Waco, American Apocalypse is a Netflix documentary series. It's one of those three-episode ones. So if you add up the running time, it's about 2.5 hours. And there's a lot of other similar three-episode sort of series on Netflix. So this is one of those. This one is a bit different. It's almost the same length as the 1997 documentary movie. And it's a little bit different from the Waco miniseries starring Taylor Kitsch. I just realized that that one was actually directed by the Dowdle brothers, but also David Thibodeau, who was one of the Branch Davidians. That's why the Waco miniseries, the 6-episode one, is very sympathetic towards the Branch Davidians. This one is not, though. This one's very different. It's a different story. It gives you more of the ickier elements that you might not know unless you read the Wikipedia page. But the first episode is basically about more focused on the ATF and the FBI sort of getting involved and storming the compound after finding out what David's up to. David Koresh, a lot of people don't know this, but he actually like had a sort of civil war with another leader of the Branch Davidians and killed him and took over. And then he declared himself the Messiah. He would have himself, all the single women would marry him, and he was like a super polygamist, but then he would also annul the marriages that were there so that he could have all the wives, and so he could father multiple children. But he was also a pedophile who went after 10 to 15 year olds as well. And of course, you know, being in power, being part of that cult, they allowed that even though it's wrong. And then of course, the FBI used the excuse of having all the guns there, modified ones. So he had about 40 to 60 machine guns and super caliber weapons, about 1 million rounds of ammunition. So that's the main reason why they wanted to sort of shut that down, because they're off in the compound of Mark Calmerl. The second episode is more focused on some of the children who were there. We get more interviews with people that were there. There's a couple of survivors, so we get a few of them. And we also get more focus on some of the FBI agents that were there, some reporters as well that were there on Ground Zero, and the different tactics they used and the cross communications, some of the conflict that would happen between the FBI and the ATF. And of course, the last episode would focus mostly on the tragedy. I always forget that Waco ends with a really large body count, a really tragic thing. A breakdown of communication from both sides, because both sides point the fingers at the others. There was a tear gas attack, and then 3 giant fires were started on the compound. So that's always, you know, sobering to remember what happens when you have such a long standoff and so many people lost their lives. But the documentary series at least offers something new and gives you the more ickier details than holding back. I feel like the 6-episode Waco miniseries definitely plays on the Davidian side being more sympathetic and hides the creepier grooming aspects. And this one, it's a more updated version sort of the 1997 documentary. So I'd recommend it if you're interested in the subject. And that's my thoughts on Waco American Apocalypse.